Milestone! I have 101 videos! Yay! Happy flags! If I could do fireworks, there'd be fireworks going off, there'd be confetti and balloons, and pass around the refreshments and the cake. So, we're gonna talk about my little outing last night for Thai food. And the recovering picky eater in me definitely made an appearance a couple of times. But, well, let's start from the beginning. We were supposed to meet at about 8:30 downtown. And so I caught the bus fairly quickly. It was the subway that was a little slow, so I was about 10 minutes late. Fashionably late, according to Andy. But I did text him and tell him I was going to be 10 minutes late, so he can just be quiet. So we walked up and down the Danforth, which is like Greek town, and he just kind of showed me around, and this is what this is, this is what this is, this is what happens here, this is what happens there, being Mr. Tour Guide. And I was very hungry, and so we went to the restaurant. And it was this little Thai food place kind of in a corner. And so we walked in and sat down in a booth. And because I'm not allowed to have Coke, I had water. He later told me that I could have had a Diet Coke because he didn't mean that I couldn't drink carbonated drinks. But that's what he said. So I'm sticking with that. I only have one more day to go on my no Coke ban. So we sat down and we were picking through like the starters and stuff, and like I have no idea what any of this stuff is, so I was just like, you pick something good and I'll attempt to eat it. So he picked a couple of different things. There was chicken dumplings, there was chicken fried rice, there was what is that called? What was it? Oh, there were shrimp balls. And there was, my main course was General Tao chicken. And he had like chicken in a black bean sauce, flaming chicken in a black bean sauce. I actually came to the table and lit it on fire, and we were both like, but, so there was a ton of food on the table. I know I'm forgetting something. Oh, sticky rice with chicken. And that was really good. So we just kind of picked through everything and took a little of everything, and I definitely ate the shrimp ball. I attempted to use the chopsticks, but like, I'm not coordinated enough for this. This kind of stuff. So I was like resorting to stabbing it with one and like, yeah, really ladylike, right? So I think he kind of noticed that I was struggling, and so we got a fork and a knife. So the chicken was so good. Oh my goodness, it's in my fridge. I took the leftovers. He let me have them. Somebody's having Thai food soon. The conversation was really good. He talks a lot, but that's okay because he has a really good accent. I'll pretty much listen to him talk about anything. He's very smart, very worldly traveled, has a lot of experiences, lots of really good stories. So he's a really cool guy, and I definitely want to do it again, but I'm just scared that it's going to be like one of those blind date shows where like the girl is like, oh my gosh, he was so great and we had such a good time and everything was so good and I definitely want to see him again. And then the guy's like, mm-mm, not interested. That's kind of my phobia. So we'll kind of have to wait and see what he has to say about it, even though he watches my videos, so he's watching this right now. And hi, Andy. Mongolian sounds good. So that was my little outing last night. It was fun. I had a really good time, and I'm glad I went, and I'm glad we finally met. And yeah, so tomorrow is Monday. I'm working tomorrow night, and then it's Tuesday, and then I go to the doctor. So I'll try and get a video up tomorrow night when I get home from work. I'll have to see how things go. I'll have to see where my brain's at. But I'll keep you guys posted. We're almost there. Almost there. So, my advice to everybody, eat Thai food. Try the shrimp balls. Don't use the chopsticks. Yeah.